would you like to eat a brownie shaped like a piece of poop? Or slurp delicious soup out of a newly sanitized bedpan? Or drink a freshly squeezed glass of juice into which someone had dipped a sterilized cockroach? Perhaps unsurprisingly, when actually put in these scenarios, most people turn them all down. Even the brownie. That's because even though these snacks are perfectly safe to eat, human brains are built to trigger powerful feelings of disgust at even the slightest suggestion of contamination. Humans probably evolved to be easily disgusted because it saved us from eating nasty stuff like spoiled food and feces. Even now that we have rational ways of figuring out what's safe, disgust still makes some of our decisions for us, even some fairly big decisions. Take the drought-prone Tri-Valley area of Northern California, which in the late 1990s built a multi-million dollar water plant that used reverse osmosis to recycle sewage water into drinking water. It wasn't an untested idea. Water recycling plants in Namibia, Singapore, and even Southern California had been churning out clean, potable water for years using the same technology. But the idea of drinking something that used to have poop floating in it made some locals so queasy that they began filing lawsuits, and the plant closed before it even opened. Public backlash has killed water recycling plants in other places, too, likely in part because party poopers called the water toilet to tap, which made it sound like there was nothing between the pooping and the drinking. Studies show that time and distance are some of the best antidotes to disgust. In one survey, only a third of people said they'd drink recycled water if it were added directly to pipes, but two-thirds would drink it if it spent time in reservoirs first, even though the pipe water and reservoir water were equally clean. In other words, we can trick ourselves out of our irrational disgust by doing irrational things like letting recycled water sit in a tank for a while before we drink it. Another trick is to rebrand that recycled water. Singapore quickly gained public support for their recycled water by calling it new water. Finally, people are more willing to take the plunge when circumstances become dire. After another 15 years of droughts and mandatory water restrictions, the Northern Californians changed their minds and asked the Water Authority to look into getting the poop water plant, I mean the pure new sparkly clean fun water facility, running again. Hey, this is Henry. I'd like to thank Audible.com for supporting this video. Audible is a leading provider of audiobooks including fiction, nonfiction, and periodicals. A book you might enjoy is Nudge by Richard Thaler and Cass Sunstein, which opened my mind to some of the hidden reasons why we do or don't succeed in making changes in our lives or in society. Like, I don't know, getting people to stop drinking poop water and start drinking pure, clean, new fun water. You can check out Nudge, or another book of your choice, for free with a free 30-day trial at audible.com/MinuteEarth. Again, that's audible.com/MinuteEarth.